Hi, it's Mr. Andersen, and this is AP Physics Essentials, video 105. It's on wavelength. And this surfer is surfing mavericks, which are some of the largest waves that we have. It's off the coast of California. But you're only looking at one wave. It's really hard to calculate wavelength. If we were to pull back a little bit, you can see that waves keep coming in. And so the distance between those waves is going to be the wavelength. And so waves transfer energy through oscillations. Remember, those waves can either be longitudinal, that's when the oscillations are in the direction of the movement of the wave, or they can be transverse, that's when the oscillations are perpendicular. In either case, the distance, or the repeat distance between those oscillations, is going to be the wavelength, and we use lambda to represent wavelength. And so if we were to look at these longitudinal waves, what would be one wavelength? It's going to be the distance between those compressions. Or it could be the distance between the least amount of compressions in those longitudinal waves. We could look at the transverse waves as well. This would be one lambda, or one wavelength. But this would also be lambda, and this would also be lambda here as well. And so it's the distance between those oscillations. And it doesn't matter where you start measuring, as long as you measure the same amount, one wavelength down. And so if we were to look at longitudinal waves in this SimBucket simulations, you can see the oscillations in the direction of the movement of the wave. And so where would one wavelength be? If you were to hold your fingers up to the screen, it's going to be like that. It's the distance between those compressions. If we were to look at transverse waves, now you can see that those particles are oscillating perpendicular to the motion of the wave. Where would one wavelength be now? Like that. But we could have equally measured the crests or the troughs of the waves as well. Now let's actually add numbers to that. And so if we're doing a PHET simulation, I'm creating a bunch of waves. It's hard to see where the wavelength is. And so if we slow it down, and better yet, if we simply just pause the video, then you can figure out where the wavelength is. And so if we look at this, I see one crest here, and then I see another crest right down here. And so the distance is going to be 3.2. But 3.2 what? I want to make sure that I have the units correct. And so this is going to be centimeters right here. And so what I would write down is 0.032 meters. Now, why did I convert to meters? It's because when we measure the velocity of the wave, and all our equations are based on meters, and so you might as well convert to it right away. Let's say I give you a problem as well. So now I'm going to generate a wave, and then we'll pause it. And what I want you to do is pause the video and then measure the wavelength. Have you paused the video yet? Because I'm going to show you the answer on the next slide. The right answer is 0.042 meters. Hopefully you got that right. And hopefully you learned to use a visual representation to calculate the wavelength of the wave. And I hope that was helpful.